Welkom Frank!
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for your presence here today and a wet and drink Stirling, but I'm sure that won't spoil the party afterwards. And thanks for your continued support of East of Scotland football. It's very, very important that we're able to reach out to a wider audience than just players and coaches and officials. So thank you for your time to come here today. I've been involved in East of Scotland football for quite some time now. And arguably, I doubt the league has ever been stronger than what it is today. And I think that's evident in the contest that's been played out this season. There's a number of people that we need to thank that have helped East of Scotland football prosper and develop. And I'd like to just make mention of one or two of them today. In particular, I'd like to thank the sponsors, Central Taxis, for their continued support of East of Scotland football. And I'm pleased that we have some representatives. I'd also like to thank the administration team that worked tirelessly to run the league and to run it efficiently and effectively. And I'm pleased that we have Thomas Brown Jr. here from our administration team. So Thomas, thank you for you and your team for your efforts in making everything work. I know sometimes it doesn't look like we appreciate it, but we do appreciate it. And thank you for your time and effort. So thank you, Thomas. Folks, by the end of today, almost 250 fixtures will have been played in the East of Scotland Football League. And that's quite a feat, actually, in being able to put these games on. And it's really exciting to know that it came down to the very last week of the season to not only determine the winners, but also to determine those that would find themselves at the bottom of the table. And again, I think that's just another example of the strength of the league. Clearly, there can only be one winner, and the winner of the league is always the team that shows the most consistency, particularly at times of trouble, times of adversity, and this year Wightham Welfare came to the fore. So, you know, the very, very most congratulations to Whitehill for their efforts. It's perhaps fitting that Whitehill should win the league this season, particularly when you consider it's Peter McGawley's the godfather of East of Scotland football. It's Peter's 50th year involvement, and I guess there's also something there in the gods that Mickey Lawson, the prodigal son, returns to the team that he probably never ever left. And I think that's fitting that Whitehill should win the league. Finally, folks, as I do, I was reading a little bit about winning in sport during the week there, and I started reading about what makes the difference between winners and champions, and I started to think to myself, it's often the case that when you win a cup, you get classed as winners, but when you win the league and the league championship, you get classed as champions. And I started to think to myself, what is the difference between a winner and a champion? And I think to myself, you know, I finally found what I think was the answer. It's perfectly articulated by a professor in the University of Hartford called Jean Hybrids. And she states the following: all champions are winners, but not all winners are champions. There's a big difference between being a winner and being a champion. Winning is merely an outcome. Becoming and being a champion is not an outcome, but it is a process, a way of acting and a way of behaving. True champions are relentlessly positive and gracious always. True champions respond to a challenge with dignity. They rise above the fray, don't involve themselves with the pettiness that can accompany long-standing rivalries. Aware of their strengths and weaknesses, champions display confidence and humility in equal measure. With this in mind, I congratulate Whitehill on the league victory and ask that they act like champions in the year ahead.
Well done.
Well done to you. Welfare.